again, and if you would like to state your name first, and then proceed with your testimony.
My name is Lily Jimenez, and good afternoon. My name is Lily, and I am 16 years old. Good afternoon. My name is Lily, and I am 16 years old. I am a current youth advocate with Juvenile for Justice, with the Juvenile Law Center. I am a sophomore in high school. I love to shop, dance, be with my family, and have fun. I have many plans for the college, for my future, including attending college for criminal justice, joining SWAT team, becoming a lawyer, and advocate for youth, foster youth. This year, I started working as a youth advocate at Juvenile Law Center. I am part of the Achievement Independence Center. And I am getting support from my case manager and parents to stay active and seek out new hobbies. When I entered the delinquency system, I was only 13 years old. I am speaking here today to send a message to the parents and leaders of Philadelphia. My mother thought going to a juvenile holding facility would be good for me. She thought I would be safe. She didn't realize that I would be abused, strip searched, mistreated, or I wouldn't be able to continue my education. I hope that by me sharing my story today, parents and leaders will realize that youth are better off staying in their own homes. I am sharing some really hard things that happened to me because I don't want them to happen to other youth. I first went into placement in May of 2016 and was in two different facilities for a total about 7 months. First, I was at a lockdown placement in Philadelphia, and it was the worst. There was a lot of physical abuse happening in this facility. There was one staff person assigned to each floor, and the staff thought that they could do whatever they wanted to the youth. Staff fought girls and male staff restrained youth, female youth, which didn't feel right to me. Staff also let youth fight another youth by giving them permission to go off site of the camp so they wouldn't be seen. I also heard about someone being pepper sprayed in response to telling a staff person no. I had witnessed one of my roommates shackled for days, and afterwards she had black and blue marks everywhere. If I act out, they would put my hands behind my back and throw me on the floor. One time I refused to go to the main room and a staff person body slammed me. Then they put me in a small room with just one staff person about for a whole day. The room was in a boys' hall and I had nothing to do in there. I had eaten around breakfast, but 9 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. they didn't let me eat anything. Sometimes staff played favorites and other youth would get multiple snacks or meals while I went hungry. The food was also unsafe. I found worms in my food a couple of times. There was no school at the facility. We had to stay in one room all day. There was no teachers, no books, just a TV, and even that was on when a staff wanted to watch TV. There was nothing to do, and I hated going there. Youth are strip searched in these facilities. For me, I didn't like being strip searched at all. I didn't want anybody to see me naked. It was very uncomfortable. When I was at the facility, at one point I had a seizure related to my medication. While I was in my hut getting ready to sleep, and my friend noticed that I was shaking and my eyes were rolling behind my head. So she notified the staff on the floor, but it took 5 to 10 minutes before anyone can help me. A man ended up coming. He wasn't even a nurse. All he did was offer me water. Another time, a staff intentionally burnt me with a flat iron while she was straightening my hair. Afterwards, I was in a lot of pain and asked to see a nurse, but she wasn't there because she was only part-time. I never got to see a doctor until I went to court 4 or 5 days later. By that time, it was all scarred up. When my judge saw what happened to me, she moved me to a different floor. I had to stay in the same facility because the other placements where I was supposed to go didn't have a bed available. Even though this facility is now closed, there are other juvenile delinquent centers where youth may be going through the same thing. It is hard for you to speak up about these things. When I was at the facility, I was too scared to open up and talk. I didn't think anyone would believe me. I didn't think anything would be done if I ever did speak up. Why should I think anyone would help me as if they are sitting there harming me? Next, I was sent to a group home in the Poconos. In some ways, it was better than the first facility, but it was still really difficult for me. I miss my parents and family. I felt so lonely and like I didn't have anyone who loved me. Not feeling that love and being away from home is the worst feeling. I can't even describe it. I wasn't allowed to have a home pass, so I couldn't even see my mother. Eventually, I heard that my family went to a trip to Wildwood, which was our annual tradition. That hit me hard, made me realize how alone I felt. I couldn't take it anymore, and I ended up running away so I could see them. Being in placement really messed up my life. I tried to go back to the charter school I attended for 2 years before going to the placement, but they wouldn't let me back in. My only option was to do a cyber program. I didn't learn anything while I was in placement. To this day, I still have trouble in school. I ended up having to take eighth grade classes, like pre-algebra, that I should already have known. I also now have trust issues with adults. Going to placement changed the way I was. I was quiet, didn't want to be around anybody else. But at least once I was home from placement, I was getting all that love that I was missing for all those months. I wish I would just be able to stay home with my family the whole time. I'm speaking here for the youth that are in delinquent and child welfare centers and going through what I've been through. I want to make a change and hope that everybody has realized that these centers are not the best for youth. Thank you so much for listening. Have a nice afternoon.
So I'm ready for this challenge.
And I was built.